Hello folks, what's going on? It's your homie here, DJ DBP or Robotronics 09, depending on where you know me from, right? Or which channel you've been watching. Today I have something special for you. The other day I was privileged or actually challenged with the task of removing a broken headphone jack from a MacBook Pro. And praise God, we did it. So with that in mind, I wanted to share that knowledge with you. I'm sure other people have had that same problem. I've often dreaded the idea of having to do it myself for my own laptop. So being that we did it and it was successful, like I said, I wanted to go ahead and share that with you. So let's talk about it. Well, first of all, you're going to need a couple of things. There's a couple of different methods of doing this. The particular way that I wound up doing it was with a soldering iron and a piece of copper wire, which I'll show you the copper wire in a minute. But basically the premise or the idea is this. The headphone jack itself, what's left of the headphone jack itself is metal. It's actually metal and plastic. And it's normally, if it's broken off in your headphone jack, you know, you can't reach it. And there's nothing you can really grab with a pair of pliers or needle nose pliers to pull it out. So the premise or the idea behind this was that if you look at, and I'm actually going to show you the actual piece that we pulled out. If you look at it, if you can see it, see those little white rings in there? See those white rings? Now, depending on which headphone jack manufacturer you got, it could be white or black, but those are plastic rings. I'm switching views here. Those are little rings of plastic. And what happens is you have different conductors, you have different rings of metal sandwiched with different rings of plastic. And so when it breaks, you're either gonna have a piece of metal there or a piece of plastic that's exposed. So in order to get this thing out, again, you're gonna need a couple of things. First, like I said, you need a piece of copper wire, which I have that. Next, you're gonna need, I use the soldering iron. So here's the soldering iron I actually use. I actually have a soldering station, which is made by Hakko. I know, I've had it for a long time. But the main thing you need to have on the on your soldering iron, and preferably, I mean, if you can have variable wattage, that'd be great. Not everybody's gonna have that. But the main thing you wanna have is a small tip. You have this tip is kind of a small chisel tip. Sorry, it's a little, there we go. I have kind of a small chisel tip. There's also like more of a pointy tip that you use on PCB boards or printed circuit boards. So you need that. Anything else you need? If you can have variable wattage on your soldering iron, that's great. If not, then you just have to be very careful. So you probably, another thing you need is probably another person to help hold your laptop or some kind of stand. I have what's called a pana-vise. I did not use this or need to use this for my this particular one. I actually had the owner of the MacBook Pro, he was there to hold it, so that worked out just fine. But you have to have some way, you're gonna need some way to hold the laptop, because your hands are gonna be tied up with the copper wire and the soldering iron. So okay, also a screwdriver, or let me show you this. A screwdriver or a really sharp, or relatively sharp, a screwdriver or X-acto knife, something sharp. And the reason what I use this for, and you can see the screwdriver next to the actual removed headphone jack. What I used that for was when I was probing the jack to see what it was and what I was looking at, it turns out that the plastic ring, which I mentioned before, the one of the plastic rings, in this case they're white. See if you can see that. The plastic rings was what was able to be seen from the outside of the jack. So when I looked into the little hole, all I could see was the plastic ring. So solder doesn't attach to plastic. So what I had to do was, you have to go in and you have to dig that ring out, break it up. It shouldn't be too hard if you have a sharp object, sharp knife or something. You break it up and you want to get rid of it. Pretty much, you know, you don't want to damage anything else. You don't want to damage the laptop, of course, but pretty much you just poke at that ring and try to break it up and get rid of it. Once the ring is removed, you should see, hopefully you see like a little bit of metal, or a lot of metal, actually a metal, maybe a piece of metal sticking up, and also maybe the actual metal of the ring. I don't have a, my cursor's not on the screen, so I can't really point to it and show you, but you should see the metal exposed. Okay, basically what you want to do, the idea is you're trying to solder this copper wire to what's remaining of the headphone jack, and then it'll allow you to extract it. But you have to get a good bond, or it'll just snap when you try to remove it out. When you try to pull it out gently, it'll snap. So you have to get a good bond. That's why you have to remove the plastic. So, all right, so let me see. I have everything. So I got, you got your copper wire, where you can get that from a coax. If you have a piece of coaxial cable, you can chop it up and just remove the copper wire, or if you go by a hardware store somewhere, you can find some copper, solid copper wire. Don't use stranded. Okay, so the first thing you want to do, which I've already done it, so it's kind of hard trying to show you in retrospect, but I'm going to give it a go anyway. First thing you want to do is you want a tin, or a tin, and basically that means you want to get solder on the end of your copper wire. So before this actually gets there, let's see if I can try to get my focus here. What you want to do is heat up your copper wire. You might have to use a pair of new nose pliers or something to hold the copper wire, because once it gets hot, it'll burn your hand. But what basically you just want to tin the end of the copper wire, where you get solder on the end of the copper wire. Without this, won't be there right now. Right now, this is just bare copper wire. You put solder on the end of it. Okay. Then also, you want to look into your jack, where your headphone jack, where your broken jack is. you want to take the tip of your soldering iron, just the tip, and you want to put it in that hole. You want to just put it in the hole and touch the back of the broken headphone jack after you've gotten the plastic out. It's really important after you've gotten the plastic out, because if you do this with the plastic in there, you're just going to melt the plastic and make a big mess. So you want to get that plastic out. While I'm talking about that, when you're chipping that plastic away, you probably have to blow it, hold your laptop upside down, blow it, just to make sure those pieces out. You'll know when all the plastic's gone, because you'll see the nice shiny metal. You may need a flashlight too, or well, with good lighting. So back to what I was saying, you poke this ever so gently into the back of the hole. Just touch the back of the headphone jack. Now what you want to do, the same thing you did with the copper wire, you want to get solder on the back of the headphone jack. So you stick this in the hole. Be careful not to touch the other. If your laptop is plastic, I have an HP laptop, an older HP laptop, and the majority of it is plastic. So if I just roll the solder iron into the plastic, it's going to melt. So you have to be really careful. That's why you need somebody else to either hold it or a stand for your laptop. You poke this in there, you touch the back of the broken headphone jack, and then you dab a little bit of solder in there. You can actually put the solder on the solder iron before you poke it in there. So you can put a little solder on the tip of the solder iron, poke it in there, let it heat up, and you're basically trying to get that solder to adhere to the back of the headphone jack. Once you've gotten that done, pull this out, then you take your bare copper wire without the headphone jack on it. Okay, you take the bare copper wire, the bare copper wire that has solder on the end of it, you stick it down in the hole, touch the back of the headphone jack, and then you bring the tip of the solder iron in there, and you heat them both up. You before you do that, you might want to add a little bit more solder back to your tip of your solder iron. There's some things, I didn't preface this video, but there's some things that I kind of assume going into this that you already kind of familiar with solder. If not, I'll have to kind of talk about that in another video. But actually, watch my soldering basics tip with DJ DVP. That'll be a good preface for this. Stick this in the hole. Stick the copper in the hole. Come and bring the soldering iron in the hole. Heat them up. Make sure you can't do it but so long, because eventually the copper is going to get too hot and it's going to burn your hand. So you have to. You can use a pair of needle nose to hold this if you want to, but you're also, the metal, you're transferring heat away, so it's good to have a variable wattage solder iron. Anyways, you hold it in there good enough. Once it looks like the solder is kind of melt it to both, you remove it, and basically you're gonna test your joint. So what you do is give it a second after you remove the heat, the soldering iron, give it a second, you should have a big copper wire sticking out of your laptop. Give it a second, and then gently, what you do is you gently start tugging, or gently start applying upward force to the copper wire, trying to pull it out, okay? If you have a bad joint, what's gonna happen is it'll snap, and then you have to repeat the process and try it again. Just keep adding more solder. You don't wanna glob it up and fill it up with solder, but you wanna add enough solder that you can get a good joint, and repeat. This particular one, I actually, like I said, it took a couple of trials. It took three or four trials before it actually here. But you can see in this picture right here, I actually wound up, because I removed that plastic, because the plastic was gone, I was able to get a really nice solder joint, a really strong joint. Not only on the, there was a little tab that was sticking out, but actually on the surface of the remaining headphone plug. So once I got that really good solder joint, I was able to gently apply, or actually forcibly apply pressure. I didn't yank it out, but I was able to increase the pressure, amount of pressure that I applied to it, until actually the whole thing pulled out. You can also do like a twisting motion too. You know your headphone jack is free or you're secure if you can twist it. So that's pretty much it, folks. There's a couple things I didn't preface. Turn off your laptop before you do this. You need to check out the soldering basics video if you've never seen it before, if you've never soldered before. Be very careful not to melt your laptop. Also, let me also preface this or say, don't do this if your laptop is still under warranty. If your laptop's still under warranty, just send it and let them fix it. If your laptop is out of warranty, like in this case it was, then go for it, because it saved you, it's going to save you hundreds of dollars. It could save you $100. More likely, it will save you hundreds of dollars. So, like I said, if you have any questions or concerns or whatever, just leave a comment in the comment box. Again, this is DJ DVP or Robotronics09, depending on what channel you're watching me from. And I hope this tip helps you out. I will definitely use it if I have to in the future. So, it works. Best regards, guys. See you guys later.